Hello.
What is going on, guys? My name is James. Welcome back to a brand new video on my channel. This is a different type of video. And yes, there is no vlog this week. I did try vlogging, but because we were so busy yesterday morning, it's Sunday today, I've uploaded this video on Sunday. So yesterday, Saturday morning, we were very busy sorting out stuff, and then yesterday throughout the day we were just enjoying it. And do you like my top? My brother got it for me. But yeah, so there's no vlog, but today I'm very happy and excited to show you guys my brand new car. Right, so about 3 years ago I uploaded a video showing my new car that I bought.
Going to work, and then when I get back I'll show you guys my new car. Right, so guys, this is my new car. It's only a Corsa, but hey. This is my new car, and
it was a Vauxhall Corsa 1.2 CDTI, and at the time it was a very nice car. It was affordable-ish. I mean, I think I got ripped off really, but at the point of getting that car, I needed a car there and then. My only option was to finance it because I had no money. It served me well. It has really served me well. I've had it 3 years and it hasn't broken down on me or anything. And I've only had to get sort of minor things repaired on it, so it hasn't cost me a lot either. I've done a lot of miles in it. Over the past 3 years, I did like 54,000 miles in it, so I did a lot. But then the engine sort of started to make a funny noise. I didn't want to have to pay out a lot of money to get it fixed, so my other option was to get a new car. And yeah, that's what me and Caitlin were doing yesterday morning. We were sorting out everything, all the paperwork, all the insurance, all the tax, the transfer of the insurance, the transfer of the finance and stuff like that. So I'm finally happy that we've got our car. The car that we have bought has been my sort of dream affordable car since I started driving, and I finally got it the model that I wanted it as well. I would have preferred a different color, but all the other colors in that specific model weren't available. So I'm gonna stop rambling on and let's go see my new car.
There we have it, guys. It's my new car. Hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure it's naff taken. Okay, guys, so I decided to go for a Vauxhall Insignia Elite. It is a 14-plate 2-litre turbo diesel, and it's a very luxurious car. Front LED lights, just generally a nice body shape. 17-inch alloy wheels, very expensive. And just overall, it's a bigger car than what I had. It's not too big, but it's not small. And yeah, this is the car I have wanted since I started driving. This is one of my favorite bits as well, is sort of the line on the bodywork. It just makes it look a bit sleeker. And as well, as it sort of comes out, the bodywork comes out over the wheels, which is, yeah, a good touch of mine. Right, so we're going to open the boot quickly. I've already filled it, but the boot space is ginormous. It's so big, which is awesome. I'm going to close that. We're going to get in. Okay, so yes, it looks different to when I used to drive in my old car and stuff as well. It's a very luxurious car for what it is. The main reason I bought this car was, one, I've wanted a Vauxhall Insignia since I started driving. To me, they're just very nice looking cars. They're very luxurious inside and comfortable. And the storage space in this bloody car is ridiculous for the size of it. So I wanted to get this car. The Elite version is my favourite model, purely because of the look of it. It looks very nice, it's very sleek. And like I said, this is a 14 plate, so it's not too old. It's 6 years old, and got plenty of life left in it. Two of these as well, which I'm not really fussed about. I would actually prefer not to have folding keys because they break very easily. But I've got two, so thank God. So just to run sort of through the specs of the inside, it's got all the windows and mirrors are electric. The mirror, the rear view mirror and the wing mirrors as well are dimmable. So when it gets darker and people have got their lights on, the mirrors will dim themselves. So I don't get a big glare of light in my face, which I used to actually struggle with quite a bit in my Vauxhall Corsa. My eyesight isn't the best. I think my eyes are quite sensitive to light. So if any form of light sort of flashes in my eyes, they hurt. So the fact that these have got dimmable mirrors is very, very good. Like, I was driving in it last night and yeah, just not a beam of light in my face whatsoever. And I had a lot of cars behind me. So yeah, so you've got heated front windows, heated back windows. You've got aircon, all the good stuff. A lot of it is touchscreen, like the fan. So to adjust the fan, all of it's touchscreen. It's built in sat nav, LED dashboard as well, automatic lights, and just overall, it's a very nice car. It's comfortable. It's not small, but it's not massive, and it looks nice. And one of my favorite features is the heated front seats. I love heated seats. I have them in the trucks, and the fact that I've now got them in my car, the fact that I can now do a long journey and stay warm, it's pretty important. So yeah, I'm gonna show you the interior side of things now, and if you are new around here, or if you've made it to this part of the video, then a like and subscription would be amazing. Yeah, that would just be good. Okay, so this is the interior. A very nice steering wheel. I just like the look of it and feel of it because it's not a big steering wheel. So, you know, I've got all the room to do all the movements. It's got cruise control. It has got hands-free as well and voice recognition. There's your volume adjustment there, and there's your dashboard. Sort of flicking through the menus and stuff like that as well. You got your light system there, so yeah, very exciting. You got your lock there and your adjustable mirrors. All four windows are electric, and just overall, like the finishing touches on this car are so nice, and I love it. Like I said, the mirrors and that mirror are dimmable, so when it's dark and people have got their lights on behind me, they dim. Okay, so this is the dashboard. You've got like your hazards and that up there. This is the LED screen with the radio and blah 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 on it. There's your volume and the power for the radio. There's your menu button, and I don't actually know what that does. Yeah. You got radio, home, media, and back button there. You got a CD drive there, which I'll never ever use. You've then got the position as to where you want your fans blowing, so window towards your feet. You've got the fan adjustment there. You've got the front windscreen heater and the back mirror, back window heater there as well. AC button, and sort of that just makes the aircon circulate around the car. This is a big deal for me. I've now gone from a manual car to an automatic. And the thing is, because this is like quite a luxurious car, well, it is for me anyway, I don't care what you say, but because this is more of a luxurious car than a lot of others, I wanted an automatic because I just want a purely driving comfort. I don't care if people say automatic cars are lazy. I've paid for this car, so I can be lazy if I want to. Plus, I drive an 8-speed 4x4 lorry every day, so I am allowed an automatic car. I'm allowed to be lazy when I'm cruising. There is the handbrake button, which I don't really use because you have a parking mode there and it pretty much automatically sets that. You've got two cup holders here and a little storage pack there where Caitlin's already stored her Doritos. That's very comfortable. Full leather interior, literally. Leather. And leather! You've got a little storage space there for the cigarette lighter and whatever. I actually put this camera in there when I'm not using it. What I'm going to do is turn on the car. Well, I'm going to turn on the ignition anyway, so all the lights come up. I literally filled up the tank earlier, and there is your dash. So on the dash, you can have either have, you know, how fast you're going. You can have the tire pressure, how much oil is left in your car, the fuel range, that, and back to normal. You can also sort of adjust, so connect it to your audio or phone or adjust the settings, which I have not played around with yet. So yeah, that's nice. I love the dashboard on there. There is the DAB radio, so adjust the volume. The speakers are very good on this car. Okay. So yeah, overall, I got this car purely for me, Caitlin, and Jax to drive in comfort. Like I said, it's a 2-litre turbo diesel, so not the best on fuel economy, but it's much better than if I got a petrol version of this car. I don't even know if they do a petrol version, to be quite honest with you. But to be honest, when I first bought a diesel car, I won't go back to a petrol one. So, yeah. It's very nice, okay? And the engine isn't, you know, like, whoa, like when you start up. It's not like, wow. But it just sounds nice. It's not loud. It's not quiet. It's, like, just right. So I'll start up. There we go, guys. That is my Vauxhall Insignia Elite 14 plate. I am very, very, very happy with it. Yeah, I'm not much of a car person, but when I'm driving, I want to be comfortable. And I've finally got a car that I can be comfortable in. Caitlin is very happy with it. She was amazing when we went out and bought this car. Put it this way, we were a bit short on money, so Caitlin literally just pulled everything out of her pocket because I know she wanted the car as well. And yeah, it was a team effort, and we're very, very happy we finally got a car. Sort of this nice, you know? It's not everyone's cup of tea, but it's definitely mine, and I'm definitely happy with it. So yeah, that is my new car, guys. What do you think? Let me know in the comment section down below. And again, sorry for no vlog this weekend. Just didn't happen. I'm 9 months into vlogging every single weekend this year. I think, you know, the fact that I haven't vlogged, but I've still made a video, is still good enough. So that is where I'm going to wrap it up. I hope you guys did enjoy. I hope you like my new car. Let me know what you think down below. And if you are new around here, then a like and a subscription would be much appreciated. I'm going to go relax for the rest of this Sunday. And I hope you guys have a good weekend. I'll see you in next week's vlog. Goodbye.